Then, John heard the worst sound any human being had ever heard, a sneeze, coming from 6 inches behind his head. For a second, John remembered an episode of Mythbusters he had seen before being arrested, before coming here, where they tested to see if someone could sneeze with his eyes open. And yep, he never saw the end. There was a sick, wet thud, a horrible ripping sound, and a scream that ended too quickly. John didn't even have a chance to turn around and look over. Hello everybody, I'm the Rubber. Today, we bring you an SCP Foundation Euclid class object, SCP-173. SCP-173 is animate and extremely hostile. It moved to the SCP Foundation in 1993, but its origins are unknown to this day. SCP-173 is constructed from concrete and rebar with traces of Krylon brand spray paint. SCP-173 is completely still while in an organism's field of vision, only moving when it isn't being watched, even if the observer simply blinks or barely looks off the object. Just when the observer blinks, SCP-173 will make a grindstone sound and move forward a short distance quickly. Despite the fact that it is a statue, SCP-173 can move fast enough to travel several feet in the time it takes for the human eye to reopen after blinking. It can literally move faster than the blink of an eye. It will advance towards its target until it is in range, then snaps its victim's neck. Object is reported to attack by snapping the neck at the base of the skull, or by strangulation. SCP-173 is apparently strong enough to snap the neck of a fully grown man almost instantly, although exactly how it does this is unknown. However, the creature is rendered completely immobile for as long as it's in an organism's sight. Therefore, personnel assigned to enter container are instructed to alert one another before blinking. Personnel report sounds of scraping stone originating from within the container when no one is present inside. However, this is considered normal. The reddish-brown substance on the floor is a combination of feces and blood, but so far, the source of these materials is still unknown. And due to the increasing amount of reddish-brown material, its enclosure must be cleaned on a bi-weekly basis. Being constructed of concrete and rebar, SCP-173 is incredibly durable, able to hold itself in a fight against SCP-682. SCP-682 is a massive reptilian beast with almost unlimited regenerative powers that is widely considered the most adaptive and durable SCP the Foundation contains. If you want to know more about SCP-682, you can click on this video in the upper right corner. Back to 173. So the Foundation personnel arranged a battle with 682 in order to test the durability of 173. And from that day on, it inspires great fear in 682. Because SCP-173 is an extremely dangerous object, hence is to be kept in a locked container at all times. When personnel must enter SCP-173's container, no fewer than 3 may enter at any time, and the door is to be relocked behind them. At all times, 2 persons must maintain direct eye contact with SCP-173 until all personnel have vacated and relocked the container. And now, probably the scariest thing is that 173 seems to have started its reproduction. Here's one of the recordings of personnel's and 173's containment. "What are you looking at?" John Avery, presently known as D-5933, shouted at the other D-class personnel in the cell. "SCP-173, what are you looking at?" came the reply. This worried John, as he was staring intently at SCP-173, and the other D-class personnel was standing behind John, facing the other direction. Then, John heard the worst sound any human being had ever heard, a sneeze, coming from 6 inches behind his head. For a second, John remembered an episode of Mythbusters he had seen before being arrested, before coming here, where they tested to see if someone could sneeze with his eyes open. And yep, he never saw the end. There was a sick, wet thud, a horrible ripping sound, and a scream that ended too quickly. John didn't even have a chance to turn around and look over. From SCP-173's Addendum 1, it was written that SCP-173 appeared to multiply, producing 2 identical copies. 2 D-class personnel were killed. It is unknown how this process occurred. Each instance of SCP-173, now labeled SCP-173-1 and SCP-173-2, is to be moved to individual cells, each following original containment procedures. In Addendum 2, it was noted down that a second multiplication event occurred. SCP-173-1 through 4 are to be each contained as per original containment procedures. Objects reclassed as Keter. And in the Addendum 3, at least 61 copies of SCP-173 are as of now unaccounted for. It is unknown how they replicated so fast, or how they replicate at all. Video evidence of the containment breach shows multiple instances of SCP-173 working in unison across multiple cells to achieve the breach. Most of the instances still in captivity appear to have formed a rear guard, blocking Foundation agents from pursuing other instances. It is theorized that SCP-173 has a hive intelligence, where intelligence scales with number of nearby copies. SCP-173 has caused a breach of secrecy for the SCP Foundation. Estimates at this time are roughly 500,000 civilian deaths across North America in the last 48 hours due to SCP-173, and hundreds of thousands of sightings and pieces of video evidence. Major television news programs have obtained video of SCP-173 and are providing instructions for avoiding instant death. And following saturation nuclear bombing on number of SCP-173 instances has been reduced. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Have you ever heard or encountered any paranormal event? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to this channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.